अंगज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनवीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपं करामयं ददाति सोपदान्ति वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपद गुरुन् वैष्णवाश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं च गण रघुनाथनीतं सजीवं साधयितं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादं च श्रीविशाखानिताश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकांत राधाकांत नमस्तुते सत्कंचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्ववानुसुते प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महावदान्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य गौर तुलसे नमो जात्मन्त ध्यामि पुरुष इति अस्यांश विभवो श्रीसर्ज पूर्णदयि भगवान् स स्वयमयम् न चैतन्यात् कृष्ण जगत् परतत्त्वं परम् राधा कृष्ण प्रणय रादिनी शक्तिरस्म देहात्मनवपी भूमिको देहभेदं गतौ तौ चैतनाख्यं प्रकटमधुना तद्वयं चैक्यमाप्तं राधा भावद्विति सुवर् नौमि कृष्ण चिरादतं निजगुप्तभीतं स्वप्रेममापामरं जो विततार गौरकृष्णस्तमं प्रबध्ये गौरो सच्चरितामृतामृतनिधि गौरं सदैव सुभे गौरेण पतितं रहस्यपद गौराय सर्वं दधि गौरातस्त्री कृपाळुरत्रो न परो गौरस्य मृत्यो अभवं गौरे गौरवमाचरामि भगवन् गौरप्रभो रक्ष मां माधुर्यै मधुवी सुगन्धिवदन स्वर्णाम्बुदानं वनं कारुण्यामृत निर्झरैरुपचित सत्प्रेम हेमाचलौ भक्ताम्बोदर धरणी विजयिनी निष्कम्प सम्पावळि देवो न कुल दैवतं विजयतां चैतन्य कृष्ण हरि आदानुलम्बित भुजौ कनकावदातौ सङ्कीर्तनैकपित कमलायताख्यौ विश्वम्बरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपाळौ वन्दे जगत्प्रियकरुणावतारं करुणयावतीर्णकलौ समर्पयितुमुन्नतौ स्वभक्तिश्रियं हरिप्रकसुन्दरदुती कदम्बसन्दीपित सदा हृदयकन्दरे स्फुरतु सचिनन्दन श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द अद्वैत गदाधर गौरभक्त वृन्द हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण नित्यानन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरि 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 राम 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 हरि हरि हरे ଅଧମ ଅଧମ କିଛୁ ନା ବାଛିଲ ଯାଚିଏ ଦିଲେ କୋ କହେ ପ୍ରେମାନନ୍ଦ ଏ ମନ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗୀ ହୃଦୟ ଦରିଆ ଭୋଲ ଭଜ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ କହ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ ଲ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ ନାମରି ଭଜ ଭଜ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ କହ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ ଲ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ ନାମରି ଭଜ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ କହ ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ ଜନା ଗୌରାଙ୍ଗ ବୋଜି ସେ ହୋଇ ଆମର ପ୍ରାଣରି ହରେ କୃଷ୍ଣ ହରେ କୃଷ୍ଣ 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 ହରି ହରି ରାମ 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 ହରି ହରି ହରେ କୃଷ୍ଣ କୃଷ୍ଣ ଚୈତନ୍ୟ ଦେବ ରତିମତି ଭାବେ ପ୍ରେମ କୋଳ ପଥରୁ ଦାପ
ଶ୍ରୀକୃଷ୍ଣ ଚୈତନ୍ୟ ଦେବ ରତିମତି ଭାବେ
ଅପରୂପ ଏଇ ସବୁ କଥା ନବଦୀପେ ଅବତରୀ ରାଧା ଭାବ ଅଙ୍ଗୀ ତାର କାନ୍ତି ଅଙ୍ଗୀର ଭୂଷଣ
ନବଦୀପେ ଅବତରୀ ରାଧା
ରହିଆ ପାରିଷଦ ଗଣ ଗୌର ହରି ଅବତରି ପ୍ରେମୀର ବାଦର ସାଧିଲା ମନ୍ଦିର ନିଜ କାଜ
ଗୌର ହରି
ଭାବେ କାନ୍ଦଇନି ତାହା ବୁଝେବ କଥ ସମାଜ ହରି କୃଷ୍ଣ 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 ହରି ହରି ରାମ 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 ହରି ହରି
ହରି କୃଷ୍ଣ ହରି କୃଷ୍ଣ କୃଷ୍ଣ
ହରି ରାମ ହରି ରାମ 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 ହରି 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 କୃଷ୍ଣ ହରି କୃଷ୍ଣ 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 ହରି ହରି ରାମ ହରି ରାମ 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 ହରି ହରି
ହରି
ଶୈବ ପାଦାମ୍ ଭଜ ଭକ୍ତି ଲଭ୍ୟ ପ୍ରେମାଭିଧାନ ପରମପମର୍ଥ ତସ୍ମୈ ଜଗନ୍ ମଙ୍ଗଳ ମଙ୍ଗଳା ଚୈତନ୍ୟ ଚନ୍ଦ୍ରାୟ ନମୋ ନମସ୍ତେ ଚୈତନ୍ୟ ଆନନ୍ଦ ଲୀଳାମୟ ବିଗ୍ରହାୟ ହିମାବଧିବ୍ୟୋ ଛବି ସୁନ୍ଦର ତସ୍ମୈ ମହାପ୍ରେମ ରସ ଶ୍ରୀ ଚୈତନ୍ୟ ଚନ୍ଦ୍ରାୟ ନମୋ ନମସ୍ତେ ଚୈତନ୍ୟ ଜନ୍ନାତ୍ମ କର୍ମ ନିଷ୍ଠେଇ ନ ଚ ସମଧିଗତମ ଯତ୍ତପ ଧ୍ୟାନ ଯୋଗେଇ ବୈରାଗୀ ତ୍ୟାଗ ତତ୍ତ ସ୍ତୁତି ବିରପି ନ ଯତ୍ କୀର୍ତ୍ତନ ଚାପି କଶ୍ଚିତ୍ ଗୋବିନ୍ଦ ପ୍ରେମ ଭାଜାଙ୍ଗପି ନ ଚ କଳିତମ ଯଦ ରହସ୍ୟମ ସ୍ୱୟଂ ଚ ନାମ ନେଇବ ପ୍ରାଦୁରାସୀତ୍ ଅବତରତି ପରିଯାତ୍ରତମ ନୌମି ଗୌରମ Mahaprabhu exhibited this mystery behind Gundicha Marjana Leela, cleansing Gundicha temple. Today is the day, tomorrow the Ratha Yatra will be held, performed. So today is Gundicha Marjana, cleansing of Gundicha temple. You understand? Mahaprabhu, when Mahaprabhu was present here 500 years ago, he did it with all his associates, devotees. He went to Gundicha temple and cleansed outside and inside of Gundicha temple very clean, neat and clean. How he did and why he did, that should be understood. What is the purpose behind it? What is tattva behind it? What is the mystery behind it? Mahaprabhu has taught us. So this is the day, that day. So we should know that thing. Thereby, we'll be able to get the mercy of Mahaprabhu and make our life successful. The purpose of human birth is to have Krishna prema and get Krishna. If we understand it clearly in tattva and practice it in our life. So we speak about that. So Srimad Mahaprabhu came to teach us how to develop pure bhakti, prem bhakti, and get Krishna. The purpose of this rarely achieved human birth. This is the purpose of rarely achieved human birth. How to get Krishna, how to develop pure Krishna bhakti, prem bhakti, and get Krishna. That is the purpose of this rarely achieved human birth. If you cannot do so, then your human birth is spoiled. Spoiled. So, Krishna has given you the chance, opportunity, by giving you this human birth. In this very birth, you get Krishna, make your life successful, perfect. Go back home, back to Godhead. No more in this material world. You understand? Material world, nasty place. Pade pade vipadan. Every step there is danger. Illusory world. The illusory energy of the Lord. Maya. Entraps your body. Allures here. Enchants. All are enchanted by Maya, lured by Maya, entrapped by Maya. Maya, the ugly witch. Maya, the ugly witch. But the conditioned souls here are attracted to that ugly witch, Maya, who presents herself as very beautiful. Attractive madam. Yes. Maya presents in that way. She presents the real as unreal. Unreal as real. Happiness as distress, distress as happiness. Maya presents in that way. Shelter as not shelter, not shelter as shelter. Maya presents in that way. Those are captured by Maya, entrapped by Maya, they accept as such. They accept happiness as distress, distress as happiness. Real as unreal, unreal as real. Shelter as not shelter, not shelter as shelter. Lotus feet of Krishna is the only shelter. Sadhu Sangha is the only shelter. Association Sadhu is only shelter. But Maya presents in a different way. That means Maya Buddha Jiva conditioned so completely under grip of Maya, thinks Maya is the shelter. Maya is the shelter. And thinks Sadhu Sangha is not shelter, not shelter. And lotus feet Krishna is not shelter. He thinks. Material enjoyment as happiness. He thinks. Maya Buddha Jiva. Conditioned soul thinks that material enjoyment, sense enjoyment is happiness, pleasure. Never thinks Maya presents in that way. Material enjoyment, sense enjoyment is unhappiness, distress. Jehi sanspada bhoga dukkha jona yevati adyantavanta kaunta yanati suramati buddha. Krishna says that thing in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Sanspada bhoga means sense enjoyment. Temporary, adyantavanta, that is beginning and end. In the beginning, maybe some little, very little, insignificant pleasure, happiness may be there. But consequence is unlimited misery. Dukkha jonaya, unlimited misery. Because consequence is unlimited misery is really happiness. Is it really happiness? Is consequence unlimited misery? Real happiness? No. Because consequence, outcome is real pleasure and happiness is real pleasure and happiness. That is real pleasure and happiness. Isn't it? Not a Suramati Buddha. Those are real pandits. Those who know this thing, they don't turn after this material sense enjoyment. Material enjoyment. They know it is unhappiness and filled with unlimited miseries. Unlimited miseries. They don't run after it. They know it is a real happiness. Real pleasure. It's eternal. It's eternal. That is the lotus feet of Krishna. That is the lotus feet of Krishna. Abhaya asoka amrutir sthala tomar charana daya tahate kono visram lavila charilu bhave bhoy. Bhaktivinoda Thakur Mahajana, Gaura Priyajana, dear devotee of Gaura Mahaprabhu, things like that. Oh Lord, your two lotus feet is such a place where there is no fear, no lamentation, no death. This amruta is all nectar. You understand? One who takes shelter there, complete surrender, 100%, he gets it. He is free from all sorts of material fears, lamentations, and death also, suffering also, no more. So that is the shelter, lotus feet of Krishna. Sadhu Sangha is the shelter. Association of sadhu, to take shelter at the lotus feet of a sadhu, pure, devotee, Sudha Bhakta, pure devotee of Krishna, who has gotten Krishna, who has bound up Krishna in his heart, who has made Krishna seated in his heart, the throne, pure heart, no tinge of other desire there. Desire for material enjoyment, desire for liberation, no tinge at all. Even there is not a tiny spot there, spotless. स्पॉटलेस प्योर संसार डियर डिवोटी प्योर डिवोटी ऑफ कृष्ण मेट कृष्ण सीटेड इन हिज हार्ट एंड कृष्ण इज देयर इटर्नली कृष्ण गेट्स प्लेजर देयर डे एंड नाइट 24 आवर्स इज एंगेज्ड इन द लविंग सर्विस ऑफ कृष्ण You understand? No other thought is there. How to give Krishna pleasure, happiness, that's nothing for himself. So say, his heart is pure, spotless heart. That is the fit place, throne, for Krishna to sit. And Mahaprabhu taught it. Taught this by manifesting this Gundicha Marjan Leela. Today, just day before Rath Yatra, this Gundicha Marjan, cleansing Gundicha temple, outside and inside, very clean, spotless, not a tiny spot should be there. Mahaprabhu did it. Thereby, has given us this teaching, what the tattva behind it, mystery behind this Gundicha Marjan Leela. Those who are serious and very eager to have Krishna seated in their heart, they should understand this. And accordingly, they should act. First thing is to make your heart spotless. No tinge of material thought will be there. Desire will be there. You understand? It will be spotless, sparkling, like crystal. Then Krishna will be there, pleasingly, happily sit there. And that is the befitting seat for Krishna. And he remains there forever, eternally, and gets pleasure there. Mahaprabhu today went with his associates, devotees, to Gundicha temple and chanting Hare Krishna, doing Sankirtan, he met them engaged, all the devotees, all the associates, and cleaning Gundicha temple, first outside, then inside. And outside, those were thorns are there, some pebbles are there, dust is there, dry grass, all filthy things are there. Completely clean the whole compound and the body of the temple, everything. You understand? And many people, many devotees are engaged in bringing water from that tank there, pond there, named Indradyumna Sarovara, cleaning. Hundreds of brooms are there, with a broom cleaning, you understand? And everybody, what he cleanses, he'll keep it in one place and make a mound. And Mahaprabhu comes and sees who has cleaned most, whose mound is very big. Do you understand? When Mahaprabhu praises him, yes, he has done nice work. His mound is little, he has not cleaned well. Mahaprabhu chastises him. Yes, do you understand? That's Mahaprabhu. Then inside cleaning. Inside cleaning. Again and again, again, repeatedly, pouring water and broom and with the brass, cleaning nicely. Mahaprabhu himself, then with dry cloth, with his own yogapata, cleanses, rubs, as if it will sparkle like crystal. You understand? Very glazing. Huh? with his own Jagapat Mahaprabhu coins the singhasan where Lord Jagannath will sit, deities will sit. Even a spot will not be there. Even a spot. Even a single dust will not be there. Such spot, such spot. Otherwise, Lord will never sit there. You understand? He did it. The mystery behind it, the tattva behind it, that first of all, I say one is very serious, very eager, that how can I make Krishna sit in my heart? So he should make his heart spotless. No tinge of material desire, thoughts should be there. Spotless. It is spotless and peaceful. Peaceful. Then Krishna will sit there. So what are the anarthas? Those anarthas. Those anarthas are like pebbles, like thorns, grasses, dust. It's like, those are like that. Mahaprabhu cleaned all these things. That means was clear of the anarthas. Girecche nana anarthare bhai. You are surrounded with many anarthas. Isn't it? Many anarthas. Four types of anarthas are there. What are those four types of anarthas? Bolo, Chidananda. Don't know. What are you doing? He's completely surrounded with anarthas, so he doesn't know. Clear up! How can you make Krishna sit it on your heart? You don't want it? Bring me in danda. Crack his head. Crack his head. Callous person. Why are you becoming callous? Be serious. What are four types of anarthas?
Material desire.
Yes.
Weakness of heart. Apparatus.
And
type of Brahm, not knowing the misconception of the truth.
Four types of anarthas. Material desires. Bhukti kama, mukti kama. Do you understand? Bhukti kama, mukti kama. Mukti. Desire for liberation, desire for material enjoyment, material happiness, and desire for liberation. In this life and after. Yaha para. This is first anartha. Second anartha, hrudaya darbalya, weakness of the heart. What is that? What is the weakness of the heart? Jageshwara, bolo. What is the weakness of the heart?
Sometimes he is attracted to the sadhana, but other times he fails to complete.
Sadhana?
Yeah. His spiritual practice. Or actually, he sometimes tries to renounce his family connection, other times he is still more attached to it.
Hrudaya darbalya, weakness of the heart, is khutinati, kapatya, duplicity. Do you understand? Duplicity is not never simple-hearted. Duplicious person, duplicity, kapatya. And enviousness, maatsarya. Duplicity, enviousness, and love, puja, pratishtha, name, fame, adoration, running after that. Desire and is not attached to Krishna, is attached to things or objects other than Krishna. Krishna tara asati. Desire, weakness of the heart. You understand? These are weakness of the heart. Hello? Third aparat, a third. Anartha is aparad. Offense. Four types. Nama aparad, वैष्णव अपराध, स्वरूप अपराध, अदर अपराध, सेवा अपराध, नाम अपराध, यू नो 10 नाम अपराध होते हैं। वैष्णव अपराध, सेवा अपराध, ऑल दिस अपराध, थर्ड टाइप ऑफ अनर्थ, फोर्थ टाइप ऑफ अनर्थ, तत्व भ्रम, मिसकंसेप्शन ऑफ द ट्रूथ, तत्व शिव तत्व भ्रम, कृष्ण तत्व भ्रम, असाध्य साधन तत्व भ्रम, विरुद्ध तत्व भ्रम, यद मिसकंसेप्शन ऑफ जीव तत्व, मिसकंसेप्शन कृष्ण तत्व, मिसकंसेप्शन साध्य साधन तत्व, मिसकंसेप्शन अदर तत्व, दिस इज तत्व भ्रम, फोर टाइप ऑफ अनर्थ, सो दिस अनलेस वन इज कंप्लीटली फ्री फ्रॉम दिस अनर्थ हिज हार्ट कैन नॉट बी स्पॉटलेस। स्वामी से जादू श्रद्धा तत् साधु संगो तो भजन क्रिया तो तथो नर्थ निवृत्ति, फास्ट सिंग श्रद्धा, विश्वास, दृढ़ विश्वास, स्ट्रांग फेथ, अनफ्लिंचिंग फेथ, अनशेकेबल फेथ, साधु शास्त्र गुरु वाक्य, वार्स ऑफ साधु शास्त्र गुरु कृष्ण, फर्स्ट थिंग इज फेथ, यू हैव नो फेथ देन नो बिगिनिंग एट ऑल, फेथ इज द फाउंडेशन, आधार, व्हाट यू से इन इंग्लिश, फाउंडेशन, द फाउंडेशन, नो फाउंडेशन देन हाउ the building will be there, stand, and what, you have no foundation at all, how it will be built, first is foundation is faith, strong faith, unflinching faith, in the words of sadhu, shastra, guru, Krishna, I have no, Mahaprabhu teaching, I have no faith, then, no foundation at all, then, how the building will stand, it will collapse, then building castle in the air, that we say, building castles in the air, it's only this thing, no foundation at all. First is Shraddha, Vishwasa, then Sadhu Sangha, that means accepting Guru, Guru Padasroy, taking shelter at the lotus feet of Guru, Vaishnava, dear devotee of Krishna, pure devotee of Krishna, Gaura Priyajana, dear to Gauranga, dear devotee of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, such a guru, sadhu, one should accept Guru Padasraya Dikya. Second thing, Shraddha. Shraddha labhi jiva kore sadguru vichar. First you'll associate, complete surrender, with humble attitude, you hear from the lips of your Vaishnava sadhu, it says, and put complete faith in it. And sadhu speaks about this tattva, jiva tattva, Krishna tattva, sadhya sadhana tattva, this tattva darsi, the seer of the truth, the knower of the truth, tadvidhi pranipateno, परिप्रश्नेन सेवया उपदेख्यन्ति ते ज्ञानं ज्ञानिन तत्त्वदर्शिनः, दिस इज प्रोसेस, फर्स्ट प्रणिपात, फर्स्ट प्रणिपात मीन्स व्हाट, सरेंडर, फर्स्ट सरेंडर, शिष्यते अहम साधिमन्तं, फर्स्ट सरेंडर, बी अम्बो, यू अंडरस्टैंड, फर्स्ट सरेंडर, फर्स्ट इज सरेंडर, अदरवाइज यू कैनॉट हियर, यू कैनॉट डेवलप फेथ, यू आर नॉट ए अम्बल पर्सन, यू नो ह्यूमिलिटी, you are puffed up, proud, false ego is very great, thinking yourself very great, intelligent, all-knowing person. So he cannot surrender. If he comes and hears, this katha will never enter into his ear. No, because he has no faith, he has doubt. He thinks, I know better, I am all-knowing person. First is faith, Shraddha. So first surrender. Pranipat means surrender, first surrender. Then here, is full faith. Then pariprasana seva. Then serve that guru, acharya, Vaishnava, sadhu. Please him. Then humbly ask. Inquiry. Humble inquiry. You have many doubts, many misconceptions, then humbly inquire. And what by he says is bona fide sadhu, guru, mahajan is bona fide. Coming in bona fide disciplic succession, gaura priya jana. And he says accept it, put it into practice in your life, then you'll get the result. As a no faith, first you have no faith, how can you get? You are not surrendered, you can't surrender, you have no faith. And this katha will never enter into your ears, no. Because you have no foundation at all, how it will stand, how it will build up. Huh? Impossible. No question at all. Adasraddha tatasadhu sangha. That means taking shelter of guru, sadhu, sangha, accepting the lotus feet of a sadhu, guru, then bhajan, kriya. Then guru will teach you how to do bhajan. You don't know how to do bhajan. Bhajan means to serve Krishna. Sravanam, kirtanam, smaranam, bandhanam, dasyam, sakhyam, atmanivedanam, like 9 types. You understand? This is bhajan, seva, service, loving service, bhajan kriya. Under the guidance, taking shelter of guru, you'll do it. Guru will teach you, guru is engaged. And by practical demonstration, he teaches this thing. He never says theoretically, practically. That is Mahaprabhu's process. Then anartha nibruti, then our anarthas will be completely, otherwise no question at all. And just Mahaprabhu doing this manifesting, this Gundicha Marjan Leela, he teaches this thing. First of all, you should make your heart spotless, free from all sorts of anarthas. That is cleansing. If some spot will be there, still Krishna will never sit there. It's not never become a fit place for Krishna to sit there. And these are anyabhilasa. What are those filth, anarthas? Anyabhilasa. That means desire for material enjoyment, desire for mukti, liberation. He never takes to this path of bhakti, rather he takes to the path of karma, jnana or yoga, mystic yoga, asana, pranayama, dhyana, dharana, samadhi, like this. This is anyabhilas. These are anyabhilas. These are all filth. These are filth of the heart. You understand? Dharpa Rupa Goswami says, Annyabhilasa sunyam jnana karmadhi anabhritam anukullina krishna anusulanam bhakti ruttamah. Dharpa Rupa says, no other thought will be there, no other desire. No desire for material enjoyment, no desire for liberation, no desire for yoga siddhi, mystic perfection, anima laghima, no. Only anukullena krishna, only engaged in loving service of Krishna and give pleasure to Krishna. Give pleasure and happiness to Krishna. Nothing for himself, nothing for oneself, no. Everything for Krishna. That is anyabhilasa, anukullena krishna. Where there are all these anyabhilasa, these other desires, other than Sudha bhakti, pure bhakti, Krishna will never sit there. The heart is filthy, heart is impure. So Krishna will never see there, never appear there. And then Mahaprabhu taught this thing by Gundicha Parjan Lila, cleansing Gundicha temple. And his that desire is that on Navarasa, it includes this. As long as I am here in this material world, I will enjoy. This is Annavras. This is Annavras. Do you understand? This is Annavras. This is like thorns. This is like thorns. This is like straw, dry grass. This is like that. Mahaprabhu cleanses all these things. For Gurisa compound. If those things will be there, it will pierce your heart. Pierce. Like such arrow, pierce. Give pain. You understand me? So first clean it off. Then heart will be peaceful. But peaceful. No piercing. No burning will be there. It's burning. It's peaceful, calm, quiet, peaceful. Shanta. The worship of the demigods, perform some demigod yajna, and they also do some pious activities. Thereby they'll be elevated to heavenly planet and enjoy their immense enjoyment is there. This is Annavras, this is like dust. These are like dust. So cleanse all these things. Mahaprabhu even cleanses. Even not a single speck of dust will be there. Finish everything. Cleanse. Just clean. Do you understand? So you may clean it, Mahaprabhu cleans all these things. And engaged all his devotees, associates in cleaning all these things. And Mahaprabhu threw all these things outside the compound. Because when big storm will come, whirlwind will come, again they will enter. You follow me? Again they will enter into the compound. So throw it away, very far away. Even storm or whirlwind will come, they will never again come again. That is what. You understand me? That is it. He did it like that. Because this dust will cover up this heart, which is like a mirror. A mirror is covered with dust. There is no reflection at all. Cheto-darpana marjanam. Cheto-darpana marjanam. Cheto means heart is like a mirror. It's covered up with the dust, all the dust. So you see, dust will be cleansed up. Then there will be reflection. Clear cut. Many, many lives, lakhs of lives, the dust are there, accumulated there on the surface of the mirror, the heart. Do you understand? Heart like mirror. And that should be cleaned up by chanting Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Under taking shelter of Guru, chanting, Asvalayam Bhaje, Asvalayam Bhaje. Taking shelter of Guru, does bhajan. Under his guidance, pure bhajan, offenseless bhajan, then it will be cleansed up. Otherwise, how will it be cleansed? Never cleansed, rather accumulating more and more dust there. You are not cleansing at all. Those are not devotees. They think that we'll cleanse it by engaging ourselves through fruitive activities, karma. But this is their misconception, Brahma. We give this example an elephant takes bath, enters into a river or lake or pond, takes bath, makes body cleanse, as soon as gets out of the river or lake, again puts dust on his body. Then what is the benefit of that taking bath? What's the benefit of taking bath? Again the same thing. So if you want to cleanse your heart through karma, it is like that. Hastisnana is elephant bath. No value at all. Only by bhakti, pure bhakti, you'll be able to cleanse your heart. No other way. No by karma, no by jnana, no by yoga. No by mystic yoga. Only by bhakti. That Mahaprabhu has taught us. Then your heart will be spotless, sparkling, peaceful, fit place for Krishna to sit. Then Krishna will sit there. Bhaktir hude sada govinda visram. Nartam Das Thakur has sung like that. Bhaktir hude sada, Vaishnava hude sada, govinda visram. Govinda, Lord Krishna, sits there in the heart of that bhakta, that Vaishnava. The heart is spotless. Spotless. Completely pure. Not a speck of dust is there, even not a spot is there. Govinda, Krishna, rest there. Do you understand? If someone takes to the path of karma, jnana or yoga, what he does? He pierces the body of Krishna with a very pointed spear. This pointed spear pierces the body of Krishna. That is karma, jnana, yoga. Like that. No question of karma, jnana, yoga. It's pure bhakti. Do you understand? Pure bhakti. That Mahaprabhu taught us. These are like dry grasses, dust, pebbles, and Mahaprabhu cleansed neatly, cleanly, spotlessly, everything, not a spot. Take on dust will be there. And throw it away, far, far away from the compound, because in whirlwind, storm will come again, they will re-enter. They'll never re-enter again. After that, some very minute, tiny, very, very minute spot may be there, and dust may be there. Very, very minute. That should be also completely cleaned up. What are those very minute specks? Dust like they are kutinati, pratisthasa, jivahinsa, this kapatya. Duplicity, crookedness, running after name, fame, prestige, adoration, jiva-hinsa, that is always envious. Those who are after pratistha, name, fame and prestige, they go to some secluded place, solitary place, and do their bhajan, nirjan bhajan. Do you understand? They don't remain in this society, association of sadhus. Thereby, they cheat the innocent people. Innocent people think a great sadhus is a great sadhu, doing nirjan bhajan. Do you understand? Thereby, those people will give him some respect. That is la puja pratistha, name, fame and prestige. And he doesn't come out, he doesn't preach the message of Guru and Gauranga Krishna. He always stays in a secluded place and does his own bhajan and just presents himself as a great sadhu before the innocent people, thereby cheats them. This is pratistha. Then nisiddhachara, we have these four regulative principles. He breaks that person, breaks that regulatory principle and says, I am great sadhu, don't you know me? I am very great. I am like Lord Shiva, who could drink the whole ocean of poison. I have such shakti, I have. Why will he follow all these things? No visiting, meditating, no gambling, no intoxication, no illicit sex. I can digest and burn all these things. I'm like a fire, don't you know me? He says like that. Oh, very great sadhu, Allah, he is very great. These bhaktas, Vaishnavas, low. Then he runs after them. All right, very great. He can burn all these things. He can do anything. He can smoking ganja. He may enjoy sex, intoxication, liquor, 24-hour liquor. I am Indra now. You see, such person. Do you understand? And those are innocent. They are cheated by them. This is Dasara, and those people flatter him and pay respect to a great sadhu. And these are lowest. They have so many restrictions. No visiting, no meeting, no gambling, no intoxication, no illicit sex. Then what is that? He can do everything and burn it. I want that thing. Why this? Then that great sadhu. This is Nishidhachar. This is Nishidhachar. This is Vrudhadrabalya. Anartha. That category of anartha. Trisanga karmi jnani anyabhasi. Krishna bhakta. Cannot develop bhakti at all. They cannot make Krishna seated in their heart. Heart is completely filled with all these nasty, filthy things, anartha. Again and again Mahaprabhu made devotees, associates pour water and cleansing the broom, then with the dry pieces of cloth, again and again and again, even a spot will not be there inside. He did it like that. Singhasan where Lord Jagannath Krishna will sit there. Then it will become as sparkling as crystal. So peaceful, so calm, so quiet, no burning, nothing, no spot. Then Krishna will sit there. That's a fit place. Otherwise, Krishna will never sit there. This is the mystery behind Gundicha Marjan Leela, cleansing Gundicha temple outside and inside. Sometimes everything is cleaned up nicely, but some spot is there, very tiny spot is there also, no tiny spot at all. Mahaprabhu, with his own jogapata, rubs it very, again and again rubs, even to take out all this, no tiny spot, even a single spot will be there, spotless, completely spotless. You understand? Completely spotless. Otherwise, Krishna will never sit there. They are all chanting Hare Krishna, doing Sankirtan, and are engaged in this Marjan Leela, cleansing the temple. And congregation only, loudly chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare. Mahaprabhu's teaching, jadya panya bhakti kalau kartabhya tada kirtanakhya bhakti sanjoge naiva. Hare naam, hare naam, eva kevalam kalau nasteiva, nasteiva, nasteiva gatiranyatan. Kali Yuga, there is no other way, no other way, no other way. Hare naam, eva kevalam, only harinam. And so take shelter of harinam and when engaged in Hare Sankirtana, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Otherwise you cannot develop bhakti at all in Kali Yuga. No other way. It's only through chanting Hare Krishna, this Sankirtana. Mahaprabhu was going to every devotee, every Vaishnava, and seeing how he is doing, what amount of this filth he has collected, cleaned, is greater mound, small mound, or big mound, or like that. Personally, Mahaprabhu was seeing it and teaching him, do this in this way, do this, rub in this way, pour again water, again broom, again water, again rub, no spot is there, clean. Him personally, Mahaprabhu was teaching like that, going to everybody, everybody, individually, teaching. And who has done very nice, Mahaprabhu was praising him. Yes, he has done nice. Not nice, Mahaprabhu was some mild chastisement and catching hold of his hand, teaching him, do this in this way, do this in this way, like this. Practical teacher. Mahaprabhu was practical teacher. Do you understand? Mahaprabhu is encouraging them. This will completely destroy all these anarthas. That nose, even a spot will be there, tiny spot will not be there. Then that is a fit place. That Hriday Singhasana in the heart is a fit place for Lord Krishna to sit. He can keep Krishna, make Krishna seated there. Otherwise Krishna will never sit there. And those who have not completely cleansed all these anarthas, and they have cleansed some, not completely cleansed, some percentage is there. Do you understand? So 50%, 60%, or 70%, or 75% may be cleansed. 25% is there. It's completely sent person, even a tiny spot will not be there. Then Mahaprabhu inflicts punishment on them. Do you follow? What sort of punishment? Not completely cleansed, 100% cleansed. Some 50%, 60%, 70% cleansed. Then Mahaprabhu inflicts punishment. What is that? To serve Hari Guru Vaishnava. Come, engage yourself in the service of Hari Guru Vaishnava. That is the punishment for you. Otherwise, it will not be completely cleansed. Then Hari Guru Vaishnava, Sadhguru Vaishnava will inflict punishment on you. If you accept their punishment gladly, get their mercy, then it will be completely cleansed. Kabe nitai chandler karuna hoibe, visaya vasana mor, kabe tuccha hobe. Visaya chariya kabe suddha hobe mon, kabe amar hrida shri Vrindavan. Narottamdas Thakur. When that day will come, when I'll get the mercy, causeless mercy of Nitai Chant, Nityananda Prabhu, that my heart will be cleansed up completely of these material desires for material enjoyment, completely, no tinge of speck will be there, even a tiny speck will not be there. When that day will come? Vishwa Sariya Kobe Suddha Bhiman, Kobe Ama Hirava Sri Vrindavan, when my mind will be completely free, completely pure, no tinge of material desire will be there, then I can enter into Vrindavan and see the Vrindavan. How Krishna is there, how his transcendental pastimes are there. Otherwise I cannot. Do you understand? I cannot. That Mahaprabhu taught us. Through chanting Hare Krishna, he taught us this thing. Namne iva pradrasi davatarati parejatratam naumi gauram. We pay obeisance to that Gaura who gave indiscriminately prema, Krishna prema, love of Krishna, indiscriminately through chanting Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. One has developed unflinching faith on holy name. Unflinching faith on holy name. Because there is no difference between the name of Krishna and Krishna himself. Abhinata nama namina. Moreover, this holy name, name of Krishna, is more merciful than Krishna. That is moreover. Adhikantha. Krishna is merciful, but name of Krishna is more merciful than Krishna. That is extra thing. And one has complete faith in it, unflinching faith. This is Krishna faith, nothing else. Dhruva Shraddha. In our name, Chintamani, this Bhaktivinoda Thakur has sung like that. Name dhruva haile nahi hoi paape mati, tarva purva paap dagdha hoi chita suddhyati. If you are fixed in this holy name, the complete developed unflinching faith in the chanting, this holy name, complete taken settle of this holy name of Krishna, there will be no question at all. The thought of some material enjoyment will enter into your mind. That means, other words, no thought of sinful activity will be there in your mind. Rather, all other sinful activities, sinful reactions, as they are from previous births, will be completely destroyed and heart will be completely pure. Do you understand? Krishna Rakhyakarta, Ekomatra Bali Jane, Jivani Paranakarta Krishna Yamane. Krishna is my maintainer, Krishna is my protector, nobody else. And he has complete faith, unfinished faith on it. Do you understand? Only he can get. Aham mama buddhya sakti, narakhi hrudoy, dinabhave namloy sogol samay. You know, this intelligence of thought of I and mine, janasya mohayam ahamamiti. I am this and that and that and that, this is mine, this is mine, this is mine. The body is mine, this family is mine, wife is mine, daughter is mine, son is mine, material, this bank balance is mine, this landed property is mine, this land is mine, this birthplace is mine, everything mine. I am that and that, this and that. This is delusion. Moha. Janasya moha mahamati. And he's completely free from this I and mine. Nothing. Everything belongs to Krishna. He is my eternal master, I am his eternal servant. I don't belong to me. I belong to Krishna. I am his eternal servant. And everything is Krishna's property. This body is Krishna's property. Meant for Krishna's service. Nothing for me, for my service, my enjoyment is for Krishna's enjoyment. That is free from completely I and mine. And always, day and night, 24 hours, with humble mind, humble humility chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Then he gets the mercy of holy name. That's the mercy of holy name, more merciful than Krishna. And he's fixed, he has unflinching faith in it, unflinching faith, strong faith in holy name. And he's fixed on it. He is never shaken up, even for a moment. Dhruva mano, very strong mind he has. His mind is completely fixed in the holy name. Now, even for a moment he is not deviated from Krishna, never. Forgets Krishna, completely attached. So no other thought will enter into his mind. He gets the mercy of Mahaprabhu and his dear devotees of Mahaprabhu very quickly. He develops Krishna, prema and gets Krishna. His human birth is achieve success in human birth, that is perfection. His heart is spotless, consciousness, mind is spotless, no? Even a speck of dust is not there. Then Krishna sits there. That is the mystery behind Gundicha Marjan Leela. You follow? And today is that day. Today is that day. Next day will be Ratha Yatra. You drag Krishna there and sit there, otherwise Krishna will never sit. You follow Chidananda. So this is the day, and this day is for you, one and all. Make it clean, your heart, everything is there. Clean up completely. And then Krishna will see it. Otherwise you cannot take part in Ratha Yatra tomorrow. Yes. Jagannath will never go there. Do you understand? Oh, any question?
Mark, you said that those with heart, lumen not clean, maybe some percentages there, Mahaprabhu employs some punishment upon them that they should serve Hari, Guru and Vaishnava.
Vaishnava, yes.
But what is the formula for those who are heart is clean? Is not the same process for everyone?
Those 100% they'll get out and preach. Go out and preach. Help others and call get Krishna consciousness unto them. That is doing good to others.
But they do the same thing anyhow.
He never hesitates. Get out and preach. Never hesitates. I am sick today, I am very weak today, I am tired today, I can't do it. That's life, real life, jivan, that jivan, life. Otherwise a dead body, no life. Though breathing, but a dead body, like blacksmith's bellow of blacksmith. Like, do you follow Jogeshwar? Yeah. Thank you.
So, Guru Maharaj, we engage in this process to increase our faith.
Yeah.
But then it seems sometimes it becomes lost.
Why lost?
As you said, some devotees are disappointed. They lose their faith.
Because they are not under discipline. They are not accepting discipline, punishment of Hari, Guru, Vaishnava. That is the only reason. I say, Mahaprabhu inflicted that punishment. Those anarthas are not 100% cleansed up. This is punishment for you. Engaged in the service of Hari Guru Vaishnava. That is punishment. And then that Hari Guru Vaishnava will inflict punishment on you. Crackhead. Crack his head. That is, if you accept it gladly, then you'll get mercy. Then inspiration is there, enthusiasm is there. Do you understand? No question of disappointment. No question of pessimism there. It's all optimism.
So, someone who doesn't accept that shelter of Guru Vaishnava, he's finished.
Yes, that is the yes, I saw many. They are all Prabhupada's disciples. So, what is that? What is this? What happened to you, Baba? Why are you so stingy? And you say, I am Prabhupada's disciple. What is that? Why are you losing? Huh? Why can't you get the mercy of Prabhupada? Huh? Prabhupada is souring, but you cannot receive it. Huh? You are losing it. Very painful. Their stories are very painful stories. I heard such painful stories, you see. Oh. Painful stories. Devotees. Become karmis now. Become karmis, yeah. Karmis. So many other desires are there. And hearing such stories, I feel pain in my heart. Oh. I feel so much pain in my heart. Oh, what has happened? Anyhow, Indradev is showering, pouring water, cleaning the dust away. You just an instrument. It not be difficult for you. It is difficult for you. Indradev is helping you. Not be difficult for you. Indradev is helping you. Jogeshwar, remove all these things. No more. There will not be even a spot. Not a speck of dust will be there. You understand? All right, thank you.
Yeah. Well, we've been to Maharaj Ki.